Well, it's one for the money, two for the show, three to get ready. Now go, cat, go, but don't you step on my blue suede shoe. Well, you can do anything but step over my blue suede shoe.
Whitechapel Gallery in London, England, hosted an exhibition called This Is Tomorrow on August 9th, 1956. This exhibition was a seminal collaborative art event that featured a variety of architects, painters, sculptors, and other artists.
Well, you can knock me down, step in my face, slander my name all over the place. Well, do anything that you want to do, but not, honey, lay off them shoes and don't you step on my blue suede shoe. Well, you can do anything but take over my blue suede shoe. Let's go!
The curator for this event was Brian Robertson, who was at Whitechapel Gallery from 1952 until 1969. He transformed Whitechapel into a vibrant, interactive space of installations, and this exhibition was a turning point for this gallery.
Over the place, we'll do anything that you want to do, but not, honey, lay off them shoes, and don't you step on my blue suede shoe. Well, you can do anything but take me over my blue.
This exhibition featured 38 architects, artists, designers, and theorists who are separated into 12 groups of 3 to 4 members. Each group created separate displays for this event with the intent to create a singular theme. The main theme was modern living and was the first wave of pop culture in Britain. The artwork transformed the exhibition space into an innovative and interactive viewing area.
Get ready now, go, 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 but don't you step on my blue suede shoe. Well, you can do anything but take me over my blue suede shoes. Well, it's blue, blue, blue suede shoes. Blue, blue, blue suede shoes. Yeah! Blue, blue, blue suede shoes, baby!
Notable contributors include Richard Hamilton, Theo Crosby, Anthony Hill, Kenneth Martin, Eduardo Paolozzi, Victor Pasmore, and William Turnbull. This exhibition has continued to interest artists, theorists, and curators as it questioned the ways in which art can be created, exhibited, and encountered by the audience. This exhibition came to Whitechapel Gallery because Theo Crosby asked Brian Robertson to host the event.
Architect and writer Theo Crosby's initial idea for an exhibition involving architects, artists, designers, and theorists resulted in the art exhibition This Is Tomorrow, which took place at the Whitechapel in 1956 in collaboration with members of the independent group.
Well, it's one for the money, two for the show, three to get ready, now go, cat, go, but don't you step on my blue suede shoe. Well, you can do anything but take me over my blue suede shoe. Well, you can knock me down, step in my face.
Theo Crosby was born on April 3, 1925. He was an architect, sculptor, writer, and designer. Working across a range of disciplines, he was influential in shaping perceptions of the built environment of the late 20th century. Crosby studied in South Africa before coming to Britain in the late 1940s. In London, he then became involved with the independent group and conceived its landmark exhibition, This Is Tomorrow.
Well, you can knock me down, step in my face, slander my name all over the place. Well, do anything that you want to do, but not, honey, lay off them shoes, and don't you step on my blue suede shoe.
Theo Crosby was one of the most influential and creative figures of his generation in design and architecture. He was one of the founders in 1972 of the design practices Pentagram. Along with being an author, editor, and sculptor, he later was the driving force with the late Sam Wanamaker behind the recreation of Shakespeare's Globe Theatre in Southwark, South London. In his 40-year career, Crosby's chief aim was to find a visual vocabulary for the built environment that was both of a fine quality and appropriate to the modern era.
But take me over my blue suede shoe. Well, you can knock me down, step in my face, slander my name all over the place. Well, do anything that you want to do, but not, honey, lay off them shoes, and don't you step on my blue suede shoe.
Crosby proved his commitment to new thinking by his forceful, energetic mother henning of the This Is Tomorrow exhibition at the Whitechapel Art Gallery. This brought together a crew of angry young people, which included the architects Allison and Peter Smithson and Sandy, now Sir Colin Wilson, the assemblage sculptor Eduardo, now Sir Eduardo Paluzzi, the action painter Magda Cordell, the sculptor Bill Turnbull, and the pop artist Richard Hamilton. It was a marvelous ragbag of new thought and the cradle of the independent group of architect designer artists who became icons of the 60s.
Well, it's one for the money, two for the show, three to get ready, now go, cat, go, but don't you step on my blue suede shoe. Well, you can do anything but take me over my blue suede shoe. Well, you can knock me down, step in my face, slander my name all over the place. Well, do anything that you want to do.
Richard Hamilton was born on February 24th, 1922. He was known for his collages, paintings, and graphics. Hamilton received his training at Royal Academy, but he was expelled. He then continued his education at Slade School of Art, where he studied painting. After 2 years, Hamilton was presenting his art at the Institution for Contemporary Arts in London. With his time there, he became friends with Eduardo Plazzi and many other artists. Plazzi showed Hamilton some collages from American magazine advertising, which gave Hamilton the inspiration to create his own form of pop art.
Well, you can do anything but take me over my blue suede shoe. Well, you can knock me down, step in my face, slander my name all over the place. Well, do anything that you want to do, but not, honey, lay off them shoes and don't you.
Richard Hamilton was the founder of pop art and let everyone know what it meant to him. In his own words, Hamilton describes what pop art should be. Pop art is popular, transit, expandable, low-cost, mass-produced, young, witty, sexy, gimmicky, glamorous, and big business. He created visual pieces that captured the energy and how strange the new technology was for the first generations to experience them.
Well, it's one for the money, two for the show, three to get ready, now go, cat, go, but don't you step on my blue suede shoe. Well, you can do anything but take me over my blue suede shoe. Well, you can knock me down, step in my face, slander my name all over the place. Well, do anything that you want to do, but not, honey, lay off them shoes and don't you step on my blue suede shoe.
Richard Hamilton was an important figure in the independent group that met at the Institution for Contemporary Arts in London. He was also a very important artist for the 1956 Whitechapel expedition, This Is Tomorrow. Hamilton created two works of art in the expedition. One of his works was a collage called Just What Is It That Makes Today's Home So Different, So Appealing? In the collage, Hamilton created Adam and Eve surrounded by the temptations of post-war consumer booms. Then the second work of art that was displayed in the show was a collaborative project with architect John Volker, which was named Funhouse. Volker created the structure while Hamilton hung huge images from advertising and other cultural materials. Some of the pieces of art that was displayed in the installation was a huge Guinness bottle, a working jukebox that played loud music, a large robot, and other pop culture pieces. His installation was an environment for sensory overload, because there was a lot going on in the small space.
Well, it's one for the money, two for the show, three to get ready, now go, cat, go, but don't you step on my blue suede shoe. Well, you can do anything but take me over my blue suede shoe. Well, you can knock me down, step in my face, slander my name all over the place. Well, do anything that you want to do, but not, honey, lay off them shoes and don't you step on my blue suede shoe.
One outside artist who critiqued the exhibit was a man by the name of Rainer Benham. Benham was an English architectural historian who studied art history at the London University in 1945. While studying there, Benham wrote his thesis paper under a professor named Niklaus Penzberg. The paper consisted of the ways that Expressionism and Futurism had contributed to architecture, and through the paper showed how Benham agreed with modernist culture. Because of this belief, Benham was one of the first people to see modern architecture in the same way that others saw old monuments and cathedrals, and influenced the independent group of the time. When the This Is Tomorrow exhibition came into fruition, Benham attended and critiqued the contents. Already known for his forceful, destructive criticism, it doesn't come to surprise that he started the review saying that the exhibit was unfortunately labeled. Benham then continued, saying that all the works done for the exhibition shared the same four ideas, even if it was by accident, and the artists involved were able to create just about anything their minds desired. When Benham completed his studies at London University, he began lecturing at the Bartlett School of Architecture in 1960, and went on to become a senior lecturer in 1964. A few years later after that, in 1969, Benham became the professor of art history for the school. In 1976, the State University of Buffalo offered Benham a job as chairman of Department of Design Studies, to which he accepted. When he moved to America, Benham gained an appreciation for the country's large cityscapes. Benham stayed in Buffalo for a few years before taking a job at the University of California, Santa Cruz, in 1980 as the professor of art history.
Well, it's one for the money, two for the show, three to get ready, now go, cat, go, but don't you step on my blue suede shoe. Well, you can do anything, but
This Is Tomorrow was an exhibition that was a turning point in pop culture in Britain. It showcased the post-war consumer boom and the new world of technology and media. This exhibition has been recreated and studied by many artists and curators. Whitechapel Gallery was changed by this exhibition, and Brian Robertson, along with the artists involved, were responsible for changing the way the public experienced modern art.
My name is Emma Davis, and my perspective is artist and artist.
Maggie Godinez, perspective is curator.
My name is Lindsay Bessler, and I have the perspective of the artist Theo Crosby.
My name is Corey Kaler. My perspective is outside artist.